What is your personal assessment of the visit by German Chancellor Scholz and his entourage to China?
It was a very important meeting for both sides, I guess, to deepen understanding, to strengthen cooperation, and to make sure that international and other tensions are not escalating. Both nations, both governments experience in the last 5 decades of our diplomatic relationships. Having said this, I would recommend something like a priority of how to handle international issues. First and foremost, global challenges, that is climate change, that is peace, that is food and security, that is supply chains, many, many other things. Not to forget health. Then we have something bilateral. Bilateral has a double layer, that is Germany and China, but it's also Europe and China. And thirdly, we have some things to do at home, both nations. We are facing demographic changes. We are facing challenges like how to guarantee innovation, how to make our economies greener, more sustainable, how to ensure that people's life is getting better, although the international environment is not in favor of this in general. There are some, let's say, threats. Having said this, I think both nations and Europe and China can contribute in a mutual interest to global challenges as well as to deepening the ties and the their bilateral relationships, and then they have a space to do their homework, so to say. I remember a conference in 1955 where your former Prime Minister Zhou Enlai said, let's look for the things we have in common and we can cooperate on and put all the other things aside. We know about the fundamental differences, political, legal system, freedom, and so on, but given all the global challenges and the homework we have to do, I think we have to prioritize and manage the differences in a way that partnership, competition, and global cooperation is possible and is deepening.
Would the Germans' approach in that regard very different from, let's just say, your counterpart across the Atlantic, as the U.S. has been portraying the relationship between China and the United States in quite the geopolitical terms?
In this regard, I have a little bit more differentiated picture, but the main thing is we cannot be interested in a new bipolarity on the globe. We cannot be interested in a new Cold War or even more worse. That is why I say all parties involved, especially the big powers like China and the United States, should develop an attitude which guarantees our global peace, full development, and make sure that we hand over this planet to our kids and grandkids in a good way and not in a disastrous one.
I noticed that the German Chancellor, first thing when he got back home, is to have a meeting with his own political party. Of course, you also part of that party, and try to brief everybody about the statement made by both leadership, China and Germany, regarding the nuclear issue. Now, sir, what is your response to that statement made by both sides?
One of the most important elements of this visit, I greatly appreciate the common statement and your president's clear announcement that everybody will not accept any kind of nuclear threat. Nobody should add oil to the fire, and China for sure will not do so. Therefore, I hope there will be a more and more active role in China, not necessarily visible on the international stage, but it is in our best interest, including the Chinese interest, as far as I know, that we try our best to end this war as soon as possible by providing international pressure and maybe the one or other incentive. The Europeans do what they can do, and I also, as said, appreciate very much the very clear statement of your president, hoping that this, not by public debate, but by strong diplomacy and strong political effort, will help to end the war as soon as possible.